Hi guys, welcome back to 52 Audio. We published a short teardown video of the first DJI professional mic a few days ago, and today we're gonna analyze it in detail. Firstly, let's unbox it. There is a list of all items inside the box. Except for the product, it also comes with a carrying pouch, two mic windscreens fixed by snap, a 3.5mm camera audio cable, some documents, and USB-A to USB-C charging cable. Next, let's take a look at the charging case. There are LED lights at the bottom, and the USB-C port is on the back of the charging case. The DJI logo is in the center of the top. The text specs are printed at the bottom, model is AS-B01, input is 5V 3.5A, output is 5V 0.5A. And rated capacity is 1,800mAh. Open the charging case, we can see two transmitters, a receiver, a USB-C adapter, and a lightning adapter are inside. And the display of the receiver can show the power and usage time. Take out two transmitters, which adopt the same design as the charging case. The headphone jack and mic are on the top, and the clamp on the back can be magnetically fixed, so you can fix it on any metal surface. The REC means reconnect, the other button means connect. The USB-C port and power button are on the other side, and the green LED light is at the corner. Those 8 metal contacts are used for charging. Next, we can see the receiver's display can show different device info. The power button and USB-C port are on the side. Two headphone jacks are on the other side. 4 thick contacts on the right are used for charging, and 8 thin contacts are used for expansion. Let me show you. Here are USB-C adapter and lightning adapter. There are metal contacts on the back. Just insert it into the slot, and you're good to go. The hot shoe adapter can also be fixed in the slot, which is a back clamp. The corresponding contacts for charging are also inside the charging case, and those contacts are used to charge the receiver and fix with screws. The overall weight of the charging case, receiver, transmitter, and two mic windscreens is 263 grams. Except for the charging case, the overall weight of transmitters, receiver, and mic windscreens is about 98 grams. And the size of the charging case is about 103, 62, and 42 mm. Use ChargeLab Power ZKM002C to charge the charging case. It's about 10 watts. The transmitter charging power is about 1 watt, while the receiver is 1.8 watts. Then let's take it apart. Start from the charging case. There is a thermal pad used to dissipate heat. Two metal blocks are on each. Two foams are on both sides of the LED light. And then the whole element is fixed by screws. LED light is actually fixed with UV glue. This magnet is used to attract the lead. The hinge is fixed on the back of the charging case with 4 screws. Here is the battery connector on the PCB. The red and black wires are positive and negative, and the yellow wire is connected to the thermistor. Remove the screws. Let's take a closer look at the whole element, which comes from Magnetec MT8651. Then remove the PCB. And take out the battery. We can see the manufacturer is Springpower Technology. The battery model is P13248. Rated capacity is 2600 mAh, 10 watt-hour, and the rated voltage is 3.87 volts. There are 4 magnets at the bottom of the chamber, which are also fixed by UV glue. Here is the front of the PCB, which is coated with protective lacquer, and the pogo pins are on both sides. Here is the heatsink. The blue thermal adhesives between PCB and heatsink are also used to dissipate heat. Here is the operational amplifier, which can provide superior performance for driving ADC without degradation of differential linearity. And two MOSFETs come from Yangjie YJQ1216A, used for interface protection, -20V, 17mA. This tiny chip is the step-down IC for MCU. And here is the 3M single-cell battery charger with high input voltage capability and narrow voltage DC power path management. Model is SGMicro SGM41511. It integrates converters and switches, so it can support fast charging. And it also integrates bootstrap diode for high side gate drive, which can reduce charging time and maximize discharge efficiency. And the MCU comes from HDSC HC32F176, which can support wide range voltage. It integrates a high precision SAR ADC, a 12-bit DAC, different communication peripherals and security modules. Next, let's take apart the transmitter. The shell is fixed by clips and glue. Here is the internal structure. The buffer sponge is covered on the flat cable. Remove the screws and separate the PCB. A layer of foam is between the PCB and battery. There is a vibration motor, which is protected by a special rubber cover. The golden parts on both sides are Bluetooth antennas. The power button is protected by a metal cover and fixed with UV glue. Then remove the rubber cover. It can reduce the noise made by vibration motor. This is the vibration motor. The circle opening is used to collect sound. And the MEMS microphone marked with 120BFC is next to it. There are metal protective covers for important components on the front and back of the PCB. Tear off the battery label. The thermistor is fixed on the battery with glue. It shows the model is SP532125. Capacity is 320mAh, 1.232Wh. End rated voltage is 3.85 volts. Remove the metal cover and let me introduce all the components. The headphone jack is marked with 211022. The green indicator light we've mentioned is next to the USB-C port. There is another button on each. This is linear lithium battery charging IC. Model is Cellwise CW6305. Those two MOSFETs are also from Yangjie, same model. This part is used for Bluetooth connection. Here is the Bluetooth 5 SoC, which integrates M4 core of 64 MHz, 192 KB flash, and 24 KB RAM. Model is NORDIC NRF52810. And this is the RF front end used for Bluetooth signal amplification. Model is SKYWORKS SKY66112. Turn to back, here is the analog switch for switching between built-in and external microphones. Model is SGMicro SGM3715. And this is quad audio ADC, used for analog to digital conversion. Model is Novoton NAU85L40YGB. The largest chip is the 8GB memory from Sandex and is used for recording storage. Another MCU from NXP is next to it. It integrates a dual-core M33 processor of 300MHz, 4.5MB memory and DSP core. And the final part is the receiver. The first thing we can see is a thermal pad pasted to the shell. Another thermal pad is in here. Remove the BDB connector and screws. And take out the PCB. The internal structure is similar to the transmitter. Take out the battery. The golden part is also the Bluetooth antennas. The battery label is the same as the transmitter. Charging limit voltage is 4.4 volts. Tear off the label, we can find the battery is the same as the transmitter. The thermistor is in here. There are also protective metal covers on the front and back of the PCB. Here is the same Yangjie MOSFET as the transmitter. And the charging IC from Cellwise is next to it, also the same. The audio codec comes from Novoton NAU88L25B, which is a cost-optimized solution for audio jack applications that benefit from enhanced audio quality and more integrated detection and suppression functions. There is also an analog switch for switching the audio signal, model is SGMicro SGM3715. Those two MOSFETs also come from Yangjie, same model. and the RF front end is also the same as the transmitter used for Bluetooth signal amplification. The Bluetooth 5 SoC is also the same as the transmitter. Turned back, there is another audio codec which integrates ADC and DAC, modules Novulton NAU88L21YG. It can support both analog and digital audio functions and is used for playback. The memory of receiver comes from GigaDevice GD25Q128E, only 60 MB. The MCU of receiver is also the same as the transmitter and comes from NXP, used for machine control and status display. Well, that's all components of the first DJI professional mic. The charging case integrates a high-capacity battery of 2600 mAh that can work for 15 hours. The transmitter is equipped with magnets, so you can fix it on any metal surface. The receiver is equipped with a display to show the device information, and you can also use the expansion slot to connect it to your Android phone or iPhone, so its compatibility is pretty good. The internal structure of the receiver and transmitter is almost the same. Many components in those two parts are the same, such as Bluetooth 5 SoC, RF front end, MCU, MOSFETs, analog switch, charging IC, etc. Okay, that's all for today's video. We spent a lot of time tearing down this complicated mic. So if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more content and leave your comments about this product. Your support is always our motivation. See you in the next video. Bye!